Darren Hinch faces contempt of court charges over comments he made on his website about Jill Maher's killer, Adrian Bailey. The Human headline hits back, saying he's becoming the whipping boy of media. 10's Alicia Morrison was at the Supreme Court.
He's no stranger to pushing the boundaries, but the Human headline says this time he was caught by surprise.
I knew nothing until the media told me this morning that I'm going to be charged with contempt of court.
Last Friday, Adrian Bailey pleaded guilty to the rape and murder of Jill Maher. That was quickly followed by a court order that the media report nothing other than these basic details. This morning, Adrian Bailey appeared in court again by video link, but this time not for his own doing. An editorial column on Darren Hinch's website was the cause of concern. Its contents have now been censored, but the details Hinch had chosen to publish allegedly went beyond the reporting limits, causing the Supreme Court to take urgent action.
The media on the Jill Maher case has probably pushed the boundaries more than any other murder case that you've seen. And also the courts are worried and are a bit flummoxed by social media.
Darren Hinch served time in prison in the 1980s on similar contempt charges. In this case, he'll plead not guilty, but if unsuccessful, he says his real fear is to return to prison. But while that's a real possibility, Hinch being Hinch is fighting back.
I'm hoping that the media goes back into court and says to the judge, why have you suppressed everything?
A court order is yet to be formally served. Alicia Morrison, 10 News.
For Hinch, it's the third time he's faced jail for contempt. We're joined live now by Melanie Davies at the Supreme Court, where some of his battles have been fought. So, Mel, what happens next?
Mel, Darren Hinch hasn't been charged yet. We understand court documents will be drafted, filed and served, probably not tomorrow, but most likely in the next few days. If history is anything to go by, Darren Hinch will go to great lengths to fight any charges. His last plight was elevated to the High Court. He was confined to his St Kilda Road apartment for 5 months, but it seems that sentence hasn't deterred him, because once again, the Human headline is living up to his name.
In the eye of the storm, Darren Hinch has again turned the spotlight on himself by refusing to be silenced.
I do think, I'm not a paranoid person, but on this one I do think I'm a bit of a whipping boy.
His career has been punctuated by gutsy battles, controversial comments and defiance of authority. Just last week, Hinch attended the Royal Commission into Child Sexual Abuse, a campaign he's been leading for decades. Naming and shaming sexual predators was and still is his mantra.
Who's looking after the children?
While fighting for life after a liver transplant in mid-2011, he was also fighting to stay out of jail for breaching suppression orders. He lost his High Court battle, but, because of ill health, served 5 months in home detention. Although Darren Hinch has faced many challenges, he's never been one to cower in the corner. He's fought media blackouts before elections and police secrecy over a threat to poison a water supply. 28 years ago, he was charged with contempt of court for unmasking a child molester priest.
In the same situation, then I certainly would do it again.
An offence that landed him in jail for 12 days.
He's always had the support of victims and their families. He's the only voice that's been there fighting for them.
Now, after more than 50 years in the media, a new chapter begins. No doubt it features an old line.
It's life, good night.
Melanie Davies, 10 News.